I just feel like we're at the point in time where everyone's kind of butting heads, and we just kind of have to wait it out until the ones that keep butting heads with us are just, you know, and take your hatred with you, you know, as bad as that sounds. Hey guys, it's Sharon. Welcome back to my channel. It is that time of the year again. It's Pride Month. As a cis hetero with a platform, while I may not have my own coming out stories, I know that some of my viewers or my lovely subscribers may. So today, I'm gonna be sharing some of those stories. And if you want more, check out the other episodes on my channel. I started this tradition as a way to make sure that every story is heard and every voice is celebrated. If you're in the process of coming out or just trying to understand who you are, it's important to know that you are not alone. My channel is a safe space filled with love, support, inspiration, and understanding. I personally think we should all be able to live our lives in whichever ways make us happiest without harming anyone. I watch so many crime shows, I feel like it's important for me to specify that part. Either way, if you're not about that, this channel might not be for you. That being said, every time I make this video, I get so many messages and comments from people all over saying how these stories have touched their lives, they've given them confidence, or they've even been able to relate to them. Because while all of these stories are different, they do have one thing in common, and that is to celebrate having the courage to be yourself. You are the only you that will ever exist in the history of the universe. That's pretty freaking cool. So grab some snacks, grab some tea, subscribe if you haven't, and let's get into this. My parents have never been super supportive of me being non-binary or LGBTQ. I came out as a lesbian in 7th grade and have been questioning my sexuality for the past 5 years. My parents don't use my chosen name that much either, and it's really hard. But my mom gets me pride desserts every year from bakeries to show a little support. I think it's very different for older generations to understand younger generations in general. So when these new or younger generations bring in or accept or show support for things that older generations didn't have while growing up or didn't see as often, it's a bit of like almost a culture shock for them. I hate saying this, but it's not surprising when this happens. I think the world changes a lot, and I think it's very difficult for older generations or people as they get older in general to process and understand that the world doesn't wait for them. It evolves and it moves on and it continues. So I feel like a lot of people that have problem with LGBTQ+ are those older conservative generations, because they just can't conceptualize it because they didn't experience it while they were growing up, you know? So that being said, at least mom is trying, and I think it's important to give her credit for doing that. It might take a while for them to like actually like really process and come around to actually being like, oh, this is legit. This is actually how it is. So the fact that they're getting a little dessert, they aren't necessarily shutting you out. They're trying. Could try a little harder always. Someone could always try harder, but the effort is there. I hope that helps. My grandma didn't know about it yet, and basically we were baking. I was so nervous about it because I had planned to tell her that day. I just went, Grandma, what do you think about guys who like guys and things like that? And she said, well, if it fits their life and yet are happy, then I'm fine with it. So I just had to rip the band-aid off and say, Grandma, I wanted you to know that I like girls and boys. And she said, I still love you anyway. Thank you for telling me. And then we hugged and finished baking. And Grandma is a real one. Grandma, see, this grandma knows what's up. This grandma is still not stuck in 1950, and we love those types of grandmas. It really isn't that hard of a concept, which is what's insane to me. Because when all these older generations, when all these boomers have problems with stuff like this, it's like, is it your own personal life? Are you the one that's coming out as bi? No. So why does it bother you? Why does it bother you what I do with my own life? If it has no direct impact or effect on yours, am I hurting you? No. So why do you care? It's kind of ridiculous, I know. How is that concept so difficult to understand? But alas, here we are. Yeah, if everyone could be like grandma, that would be chef's kiss. Great, amazing, grandma for president. When I came out as a lesbian, my mother said that she was supportive, but then she'd always say, when you get a girlfriend or a boyfriend. And I think that it is not supportive since I came out as lesbian, not bi, pan, or anything else. Yeah, this is kind of like, I feel like the parental denial. I do feel like mom is kind of like grasping onto this little bit of hope, because you know, like every parent's dream is for their kids to have kids so they can have grandkids. So I don't fault her for that, I understand that. But I also understand where it may not be completely supportive. supportive because it's like, hey, no, I am a lesbian, not a boyfriend. The whole point of a lesbian is no boys, you know? I would maybe have a sit down with mom and honestly be like, hey, so when you say this stuff, it doesn't actually feel like you support me and that I'm actually heard. And I think that is probably the most important thing I'm gonna say throughout this entire video is just communication is key. And I say that in so many different videos. Like if something is bothering you or if you don't like something, you have to speak up about it and you have to genuinely tell the person that is making you feel uncomfortable, this makes me feel uncomfortable, because how else would they know that it is bothering you? And if they don't do anything to change it or to try to improve, at least you know, because you gave them the heads up of, I don't like this. So communicate your feelings. If you don't like something, don't be afraid to speak up. When I came out to my friend, she said, I already knew you were bisexual. I was pretty confused since we don't have any mutual friends and she couldn't have known, but then she told me I just gave off a very bi vibe and we laughed about it. That's probably some of my favorite coming out stories, is when you tell someone and they're like, yeah, dude, did you think that I had no idea? Because it's like pretty darn obvious. I actually already knew that. Which is kind of sad because then you're over here stressing and like thinking about like worst case scenario. Meanwhile, your buddy or your family's just like, yeah, we've been new. Tell me something I don't know. I came out to my mother about 4 times over the last 2 years, mostly because she's apparently allergic to talking about it. And I just can't let her ignore it because I'm not coming out about my sexuality. I'm coming out about my gender. I'm a guy and she needs to stop pretending otherwise because it's getting ridiculous. I would have honestly preferred she just get it over with and tell me she doesn't love me anymore, I'm not her kid, etc. But instead, she never talked about it. When I did manage to talk to her about it, it boiled down to a few things. Firstly, she doesn't believe I'm trans and probably never will. And secondly, she can't bring me happiness. I don't know what voodoo shit she thinks I expect of her, but all I want is for her to stop misgendering me every sentence and start using my actual name. Apparently, she's also been silently compromising with me by allowing me to get masculine clothing, which I should be allowed to get regardless. And she also had no problem outing me to several people without me knowing. I did manage to squeeze an apology out of her for not talking to me about this, but considering she went right back to ignoring it after the conversation, I don't think much of it. Things aren't really looking better since I still have to live with her for X number of years, but hey, at least I'm still alive. Sharon, if you do end up seeing this, thank you for being an ally. Wish me luck. Best of luck. I love you and I support you and we all do as well. And if you don't, literally click off this video. Anyways, this is so hard because I obviously can't relate to this. I can only imagine what it feels like. And I do know that it is a very difficult position to have someone that you love or someone that you are meant to love and someone that is meant to support you like a family figure, and how difficult it may be to see eye to eye with them or just get something to just click with them. I understand that feeling. I can't understand how even more difficult it must be when it's something about like your gender. That being said, I don't know why people make such a big deal about gender. Gender is a social construct. Sex is not. And I feel like the big issue with people nowadays is not understanding that sex and gender are two different things. Sex is what you are biologically born with, male or female, if anything, even intersex. Gender, that is a social construct, because a social construct is basically something that society has created and deemed to just kind of like exist. It's a concept that society was like, this is how it is and we're gonna live by it. That's like boys and the color blue, or girls and the color pink. Boys are playing with firefighters, girls are playing with Barbies and ponies and dolls, whatever. We created that concept. We made it like that. And I just think that's so difficult for older generations to understand, because they do think that sex and gender are the same and they just think this is how you have to live, when in reality we don't have to live that way at all. We live however we want to live, you know? So that being said, I hope mom comes around. It's just, this is tough. I really do wish you the best of luck. It was the week of my graduation from high school and my grandmother and I were driving somewhere. I eventually just said, I'm gay. And she said, well, I'm quite happy too. And part of me was like, okay, we're good. But I ended up saying, no, I am a homosexual. And she was like, yeah, I got that. Love you, grandma. I love this grandma too. Always kind of like forget that gay means happy. So the fact that grandma was like, yeah, me too, that is so precious and so cute. And again, I repeat, grandmas, be like this. I know you can. If she can get it, I don't know what is every other boomers, not even boomers, because grandparents are like older than boomers. Every other older person can get this if grandmas can get this. That's what I'm trying to say. I had been questioning for a while, and one day I went to go see Chicago the Musical with my mom. During the opening, I couldn't decide if this one male dancer or this female dancer was hotter, and I watched both of them the whole time. After the show, I was like, mom, I'm bi. She just laughed and said, okay. It's really not that difficult. difficult to be like this. Like, the fact that mom was just like, okay, that's literally how all of these conversations should go. You tell someone, this is my sexuality or this is my gender. Okay, period. Not okay, but, or just a straight up but. Because again, I ask, what impact does it have on your life? None, because it is not your life. You are not the person who is this sexuality or this gender. It is someone else. So just accept it. Good for mom. Everyone in my family is pretty religious and no one is gay, so that made it that much harder. I started dating this girl in my class. I would always tell my mom it was a girl's night, so she didn't suspect. One day I just texted her saying I'm gay and I'll be staying at my girlfriend's house. When I got home, my mom asked if I was serious. I said yes, and this woman really said, good, at least you can get pregnant. My whole family is very supportive, and looking back, I over-exaggerated it. P.S. I love you. P.S. I love you too. My favorite part about this is mom being like, oh, that's fine. You can't get pregnant. I'm okay with that. Yes, that is a plus sign. Even though if we're getting technical, as long as you have a vagina, you can always still get pregnant, even if it's not actually using, you know, like a male's tool. There's also artificial insemination. If you haven't checked out Jane the Virgin, yeah, girl never even had sex and she had a baby. But that's just besides the point. That's me just actually getting technical right now. I love that for you and I love that for mom. I came out to someone who I thought was my best friend. I'm bi and she was like, why are you telling me this? I'm confused. I don't know what that means. I felt rejected by her and she doesn't understand anything with LGBT or pride. I don't think your friend or someone you love, like a family member, not understanding your sexuality or your gender or your identity automatically means that they don't support you. There's a possibility this friend wasn't rejecting you. They just truly don't understand. And that's okay and that's expected, because sometimes you do have to sit someone down and explain to them and be like, well, this means this. This is how I feel. This is what I would like to do moving forward. Like, the fact that this friend was just like, I'm confused, I don't know what that means, that should be clue to be like, okay, let me explain it to you, versus just assuming that they're like, yeah, I don't know what that means, screw you, I'm rejecting you. You know, it's not a bad thing to have to educate someone, is what I'm trying to say. And if they still don't support you after that, then honestly, trash took itself out. Like, gotta weed out the bad ones, because you do want someone that's gonna support you. And if you gotta teach them a little bit, that's okay, as long as they support you. I, 27, came out as pan and gender fluid when I was 11. My mom has hated me ever since. My dad never cared. My sister was 4 at the time, so when I left my family behind, I came back for her when she was 18 because she never judged me and always loved me for who I was. I now live with my partner and my little sister, and we are a happy family, free of the judgment that hurt us as kids. My partner's parents, however, treat me and my sister as their own, and we haven't looked back since. This is such a bittersweet story, because I'm happy that you've found a loving and happy home. It just sucks that it couldn't be with your own parents, or your own parents couldn't have given you that. I don't understand how a parent could ever just not love their child or disown their child for how their child feels, what they identify as, who they love, just who they are. That's absurd to me. It's just, it's insane, and it's sad that it happens. Because again, I ask, mom, how am I harming you by being gender fluid? It's ridiculous. You'd think you'd love your kid no matter what, right? So I'm sorry that that never happened for you, but I'm very happy that you did find a family to give that to you. And I understand that, like, this is a common fear when coming out or trying to come out or just already being out, is like your family not supporting you. You can't pick your family, but you can pick if to let your family steal your happiness or not. Do with that what you will. It was in a game of truth or dare. My cousin asked me if I was straight. I froze and said, next question. And she asked me if I was gay. I said no, but I asked her if she was gay. She said yes. Well, half. I just said same. That's how we both came out to each other as bisexual. Love that for you guys. So, real question, if you're bi, you're not technically half gay, you're full gay. Because gay is anything that's not straight, right? Now I'm asking to be educated. Or are you? I don't know. Someone please educate me now. You're still just gay, right? Either way, I'm happy for you too. 3 years ago, my mom looked through my device and saw my Pinterest board about LGBT. She went and looked through my texts as well and saw my text about being bisexual. She told my family and was like, she doesn't act gay. Well, she went and asked me about it. I was ashamed, so I kept denying and saying I just didn't know what it meant. Only a few of my friends know I'm bisexual, and I still regret not coming out. Probably should have added my family is super religious and homophobic. Yeah, that's the part. Religion can be a bit of a monster, huh? That sucks. I think what bothers me most about this is mom being like, she doesn't act gay. And how is a gay person supposed to act? That's such a stereotype and extremely generalizing. I think if you really regret not coming out to your family, that's something to really think about and really consider doing again if it bothers you that much. People can be very religious and can be very homophobic, but the story could change if it's someone that they know and love. And I'm not saying it will, because I don't know your family personally, because obviously we've seen some bad families, we've seen some great families. So I think this really just depends how your family would react. I again would like to think that your love for your kids should trump your own personal beliefs. So this is just really something you have to gauge and you have to really think about and really determine if it is something you want to do. I was 17 years old when I came out to my mom. Keep in mind, I'm from a Mexican household, so you can imagine how a conversation like this would go. My mom was in the kitchen cooking and I was sitting at the kitchen table when I told her I had something to tell her. She turned and waited for me to say something. That's when I said I was bisexual. My mom wanted me to explain what that meant. Halfway through explaining, I started to cry. My mom rushed over and hugged me and said, "Está bien, eso no es malo, it's okay, that's not bad. Tú eres mi hija, yo siempre te amaré. You are my daughter and I will always love you." I have never felt more relieved in my life, and that is how every single conversation should go. I'm not gonna lie, I was very worried at first, because the second she said Mexican household, me being from a Hispanic household, I'm like, That's the problem with Hispanic culture, is Hispanic culture is very traditional. Lots of machismo, it's all about the patriarchy, it's all just very toxic, to be honest. And a lot of the older generations, or the older people that grew up in those cultures, they never really realized how toxic it was, and then they keep passing it on to newer generations of their family. What I love about our generation and generations younger than us is the fact that we're calling out all this toxicness and being like, yeah, no, we're not doing that anymore. This isn't how it should be. So I'm very happy that mom was also like, hey, like, that it's okay. I still love you. So love that for you. I wish I had one. The only person I've come out to is my cat, LOL. And there's nothing wrong with that. I don't think people should have to come out if they don't want to come out. You do whatever you want to do and whatever you feel is right and whatever makes you happy. Don't feel like you have to do something for someone else. And if that means only saying it to your cat, so be it. This last one says, I sent my cousin a screenshot of my Instagram bio with my preferred name, pronouns, gender identity, and sexuality for her to announce to our whole family for me on YouTube. Surprise, this is my cousin's coming out story. So, family watching this video, you know which cousin I'm talking about. Yeah, this is like one of those stories where it's like, yeah, we've been new, but it's okay. I'ma still share your story. I got you, cuz. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it is giving you some comfort, giving you some insight, maybe giving you some confidence or some inspiration. If I didn't get to share your coming out story today and you would like to share it with us, please do so in the comments below. I do want to emphasize that, again, I may not be able to personally relate to you, but I will give you a platform. If there's any questions or advice or concerns that you may have in the comments, please have those discussions in the comments and I'll try my best to jump in when I can. But obviously, you may know something more than I do, and that's totally okay. We're here to love and support each other as much as we can. Now, that being said, shout out of the day goes to Ashton on Instagram. Thank you so, so much. If you'd like to be shout out of the day, just follow me on my Instagram and stay active. That's also how you get bonus content. And also follow your girl on TikTok for even more content. But that being said, I hope you guys have a happy Pride Month, or had a happy Pride Month. And I hope that you are happy, because you deserve it. I love you. Bye.